Okay, let's get into the meat and potatoes of my Form 3 Plus review mini-series. Print quality, speed, and the software. The parts that a 3D printer produces should be the number one reason why you're getting one in the first place. And at the end of the day, by what means a 3D printer makes that happen should be more or less irrelevant. But how fast it gets there and how many hoops you will have to jump through in the process, that very much does matter. So let's check all that out right after we check out today's sponsor, DataCamp. DataCamp is a great way to learn about working with data and making sense of small and big datasets. Just want to pick up a specific skill that you need to complete a task or actually prepare for a new job? DataCamp has got you covered, and their gamified experience is sure to keep you motivated while you complete their online courses at your own pace. They cover topics from machine learning over marketing analytics to visualizations. Become data fluent today and check out the first chapter on any DataCamp course for free using the link in the description below. Thanks again to DataCamp for sponsoring this video. I find that print quality on the Form 3 Plus is complicated because it's not directly comparable to MSLA machines. So let's start with something that's a bit easier to quantify, print speed. So here there is also not one single fixed factor like the Form 3 Plus is X percent slower or faster than, for example, the Prusa SL1S. Print speed varies with the resin you choose, and how fast the resin gets cured actually makes more of a difference on LFS, low force stereolithography printers like the Form 3 Plus, than on MSLA, a masked stereolithography apparatus like the SL1S. Because MSLA already spends very little time actually exposing the resin and more time on that peel cycle, which is something you cannot really speed up, while LFS spends more time on the exposure itself, so that becomes a bigger variable time chunk. And the other thing is, MSLA does not care how much you fill up each layer. The LCD just exposes the entire thing at once, while LFS has to trace out more area with its laser dot if you're using more of the build area. So if we compare print times of the Strata Miniatures Rogue with support and all printed like this, at a 50 micron layer height, printing one on the Form 3 Plus takes about 2 hours, and 1 hour on the SL1S. But to show the maximum difference, we can fit up to 8 of the minis on the SL1S at one time, and it's still going to be the exact same time at 1 hour, while the Form 3 Plus now estimates 7 hours of print time for completing the same 8 models. This is, you know, quite a detailed model, so I tried with a less detailed one, and that drastically reduces the advantage that MSLA has in this case. But in real-world print times, it's still going to take 3 times as long. Because the thing is, with the estimates in Formlabs preform, I had to consistently add pretty much exactly 50% to get to the real-world print time. A 2-hour, 15-minute print actually takes 3.5. An 8-hour print actually takes 12. So here are some print time comparisons with the corrected times for the Form 3 Plus against the SL1S. And yes, some parts just don't fit on the SL1S, it's just a less capable printer in that regard. I know this isn't the fairest of comparisons, but I find that with the print times on the Form 3 Plus, it pushes many prints into overnight territory instead of still being completed on the same workday, and you then being able to start the print for the next iteration that is then going to be ready the next day. So with this sort of throughput and print times, I wouldn't put the Form 3 Plus into the it's going to run 24/7 to just churn out parts category. Well, it would have to run that much if you were trying to do any sort of volume with it. But in stark contrast, I think the software package would actually be very well suited for that. I believe the way that Formlabs intends you to use the Form 3 Plus is through their cloud connection, and that's what I did. You can also use it with a direct local network connection too, or through USB if you can't use the cloud service or a network for whatever reason. But Preform is the software you will be using with the Form 3 Plus or any of their other machines. You're not going to be setting up your own slicer or anything. And that's good. It's good software. You can actually download it for free yourself too and use it as much as you'd like. But overall, it fits in very well with the theme of the rest of the printer. That is, hide everything that you as the user won't need to worry about, and just give you the core tools that you actually need. So in Preform, the most complex settings menu is the options you can set for configuring how support material gets generated. You mostly don't even need to touch those. I've only ever had to increase the support density on this first Steam Deck print, and then the second one printed pretty much perfectly. Everything else is really simple. It's got checks for how well a model is going to print based on its geometry and orientation. It's got an auto align tool, auto layout, auto support. You can do all those things manually, but you don't have to. I found the auto orient tool to be a bit confusing, as it always gives you a different orientation every time you run it. And then basically you get to decide what's going to work and what won't. But in that case, I could just as easily orient my parts by hand. I was expecting something like Imprusa Slicer, where you get to choose what aspect you want to optimize for, and then it gives you the one optimal orientation for that. Also, in Preform, sometimes it decides to orient the part in a way where it doesn't even fit inside the printer, and in that case, of course, you will have to manually align it yourself anyway. The preset is to always print everything with a large brim and suspended in supports. You can print directly on the build plate, but I assume because the printer doesn't have any build plate tramming or adjustment, the first couple layers are printed really thick, and you can feel that with the elephant's foot on here. That doesn't really matter if it's just doing the brim, you're throwing that away anyway, but if it's already printing your part at that point, the first millimeter or so might get squished and will end up with less detail. One thing I noticed was that Preform was feeling rather slow, especially on detailed models like this guy, and at least on the quad-core i5 laptop with 8 gigs of RAM that I usually use for, you know, live streaming and using these printers. So I benchmarked again on my Threadripper workstation with 64 gigs of RAM and broke down the times for importing, auto-orienting, and at this point on, with the same orientation between the slicers, layouting, calculating print time, and then exporting, with a simpler model and a larger, more complex one. And in both cases, Preform was much, much slower than what I was used to from Prusa Slicer, especially when adding support material. And Preform repeatedly crashed on me here when trying to update support material after already having generated it once. But that might just be something with my setup though. Exporting was also quite slow, but it also includes slicing the model in that step and then uploading it to Formlabs servers. With a more complex model though, like the 3 million polygon hollowed out Salty McCready that I keep using, you're going to be spending at least 10 minutes preparing the file with your computer CPU pegged for a large part of that time. And yes, it did actually make good use of all 24 CPU cores, so give it all we've got. On the upside though, again, Preform is a pleasure to use, with great visualizations of what areas are critical on your print, and even small details like fading out the brim as you look at your parts from the underside. What I would like to see though is a hollowing feature for artistic models like this one, that otherwise you would have to print as a solid block. Formlabs recommend using Mesh Mixer for that. I used, again, Prusa Slicer and a fictional large volume SL1S profile because it can quite easily export the processed STL files from there. So what about print quality? Like I alluded to earlier, it's not quite a clear-cut answer. On the one hand, the Form 3 Plus definitely delivers what you would expect from a resin printer. Fine details that get reproduced perfectly, no visible layer lines, and high mechanical accuracy. The Form 3 Plus does all of these perfectly, and parts fit to each other and to other real-life components really well. But that's something that you can expect from any resin printer these days, let alone one that costs 4.5 grand. I did notice that parts printed on the Form 3 Plus looked more like professionally injection molded parts than any 3D printed parts I've ever done before. They don't have that shimmer or sheen that gets created by parts being made from individual voxels on an MSLA printer, and those essentially have 6 little square sides, but the surface here on the Form 3 Plus is more continuous because it does trace out the outline of each layer as a vector. But I don't know if this is an artifact of that effect or if it's something that's actually measurable, but the prints off of an SL1S, these guys, actually looked crisper to my eyes than the ones from the Form 3 Plus. For reference, each pixel on the SL1S is slightly smaller than 50 micron or 2000 in size, while the laser spot on the Form 3 Plus is 85 micron or 0.1 thou, plus the effect of having to walk in and out of detailed areas, which again reduces its ability to reproduce those super crisp details. The other thing I noticed, and this really is just complaining on a very high level, is that large, smooth surfaces like the screen area on the Stream Deck seem to have some streaks that catch light just a bit differently, and those line up with where the rollers of the LPU move along the x-axis. This is only an issue though if you plan on showing the parts straight off the printer and need them to look flawless, but any sort of post-processing will easily cover that up. What's important though is that print quality is consistent and predictable, and that's in large parts a result of how closely software, hardware, and materials are intertwined on the Form 3 ecosystem. We get into the ups and downs of that in the next video, but to close our print quality, it's really good. I think I expected next level fine detail reproduction, because that's what you kind of associate with this thing having a freaking laser, but it doesn't do that. In that regard, it's getting beat by MSLA. It does create superbly professional looking parts, but it does take its sweet time for that. In the next, and I promise last video, of the Form 3 Plus review series, I'm going to take a look at usability, which is one of the extremely strong points of the Form 3 Plus. I'll talk about the lock-in that comes with achieving that, and I'll draw a conclusion to see who exactly this machine is made for. Thank you all for watching, keep on making, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!